What's up, young man? It's your boy iJobShot23, back at again another video. And first thing first, make sure you guys give this video a like, subscribe if you're new to the channel for more great content like this. And I got you, you know what I'm saying? Now, anyways, what if I told you that if you guys go on YouTube right now as you speak, if you go on YouTube, you will not find no build that's called a two-way slashing playmaker at a small forward position. Yes, there's a such thing as a two-way slashing playmaker, a small forward. I know, like, you could go on YouTube right now and check it out, you will not find those videos about it. So pretty much what I'm trying to say is that I'm the first person to make that build. Okay, probably not the first person, maybe someone's probably made that build before but hasn't uploaded to YouTube or something. But if you guys are watching this video, yeah, I'm pretty much the first person to upload this video on YouTube for this build. Now, anyways, so check this out. So in order for you to make this build, just watch what I'm doing on the screen. You know what I'm saying? So far I got 7 finishing badges, but in total you're gonna see how much you're supposed to have. So anyways, in order for you to make this build, you gotta make sure you max out your shot close, your driving layups, your driving dunks, okay? So you're supposed to end up with 82, either 82 or 83 driving dunk, I don't know, you could see on the screen. Make sure you max out your shooting, you're supposed to get 10 shooting, yes. So it's pretty much the same thing as you making the two-way slash payment at the point guard. And then pay attention for defense. What I did for defense? Defense, you're supposed to make sure you only get 14 defensive badges. And then for your defensive rebounding, make sure your defensive rebounding is the same thing as your offensive rebounding, which both of them is at 82 right now. If you go higher than that, you will not get the name as you being a two-way slashing playmaker. You're gonna get the name as a slashing playmaker. So if you want the name as a two-way, just follow what I'm doing, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like I just created this build like a couple days ago, you know what I'm saying? I think 1 or 2 days ago, you know what I'm saying? I'll just experiment and this and that. So anyway, so you're supposed to end up with 12 finishing, 10 shooting, 14 playmaking, and 14 defense. That's what you're supposed to have, you know what I'm saying? Make sure you guys copy this stuff if you want to create this build, you know what I'm saying? Make sure you guys follow all of this. If you follow all of this stuff, right, you will get a two-way slashing playmaker, you know what I'm saying? So just make sure you follow all this. Now for the body shape, it's up to you. You could make it slight, defined, or built. I just went with builds because, like, I just don't like how my guy, like, I don't want my guy to look too skinny, you know what I'm saying? I want to make sure my guy's muscle in him, this and that. So I decided to go build. Now pay attention to this, pay attention. Now if you either go 6'5 or 6'6, you will still get a name as a two-way slashing playmaker. Please do not make him 6'7 or 6'8. If you're making that, you will not get a two-way slashing playmaker. So if I were you, you should make this build 6'6. You know what I'm saying? Because with 6'6, like, you're still gonna get your counter dunks at 84, which you're getting the normal ones, and you get elite counter dunks as well as you're going up towards overall. Once you hit, I think 96 or 97, I'm pretty sure 96, you will get it. And us, and your ball control is at 83, so yes, you could dribble and you could momentum once you hit 96 or 97, either one. So that's pretty good. Unless if you choose the Playmaker takeover, which I'm about to show you which takeover I end up picking with. So the pound, so listen, so this is the most important step of making this build. Like, this step is important. The only way you will get the name as a two-way slashing playmaker is you have to make this weight 180. You have to. Now you guys are gonna ask, Chop, why do you have to make this build 180? 180 is too skinny. Listen, bro, if you're trying to get a name too, we're just making 180, bro. And with 182, you're still a small forward, you're 6'6, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're not as skinny, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, your guy may look skinny, but trust me, when you use him, like, you're not really gonna be like, you're not gonna feel like he's, you know what I'm saying, he's getting bullied around, this and that. So just make him 6'6 and make sure your bounce is 180. If you go further than 180, you're not getting a two-way slashing playmaker. I'm sorry, it's just gonna either call you a facilitating finisher or a slashing playmaker. So if you're trying to get a name. Now listen, for the takeover, the only thing I would tell you is that you could choose any takeover that you want for this build. It doesn't matter. So let's just say you choose a playmaking takeover. Yeah, it's gonna call you a two-way slashing playmaker. You know what I'm saying? It is because, you're 6'6" and you weigh 180. So it's much the same thing as Ukraine at the point guard. Yeah, obviously I know that the downfall about this build is obviously it's not. You're getting less badges than Ukraine, the point guard version of the two-way slashing playmaker. But come on, like a small forward, like this is actually pretty good. You know what I'm saying? This is Sire Bear version as a facilitating finisher, just a little bit. You know what I'm saying? It's, you know, some pros, some cons between this build versus a facilitating finisher. So as you guys see, I chose the glass can takeover that will also give you two-way slashing playmaker. If you choose a slashing takeover, that will also give you a two-way slashing playmaker. So either one is fine. You know what I'm saying? You could choose either one of them. It's fine. Any takeover that you choose, you still be a two-way slashing playmaker. But the takeover that I actually chose was playmaking, because I just wanted to break ankles and just go straight into the rim and just dunk on y'all. You know what I'm saying? Because if your boy standing that paint, I will dunk on you. You feel me? So anyways, you could either choose any takeover that you want. So I just end up choosing the playmaking takeover. You know what I'm saying? This is the final time I'm showing y'all which takeover that I chose. Which I chose the playmaking takeover. You feel me? So that's what I did. So anyways, I'm gonna get to the badges. You know what I'm saying? Now, I'm the first ever to make this build on YouTube. If you go on YouTube right now, I'm telling you, you will not find this build. So I want you guys to just make sure you hit that like button and make this build for yourself. You know what I'm saying? Let me know in the comment down section below, like, how do you feel about this build and you making the build? Like, do you like using, like, do you feel like this build is one of the best small forward builds in the game? Obviously it's not one of the best small forward builds in the game, but it's pretty much a taller version of you making a two-way slashing playmaker at the point guard. Instead of you making 6'5", you're pretty much 1 inch taller, so 6'6", you know. So obviously, like, you're getting less badges, but come on, like, this build small forward, you could play point guard at Jordan Rex Center. Like, you could pretty much be going crazy. So anyways, this is what I did for my finishing badges. All person go counter finisher, fancy forwards, silly finisher, and random finisher. Only just because with fancy footworks you could do hop steps, euro steps, euro dunk, hop step, dunk, this and that. You could do that. Counter finisher obviously because it's gonna help you dunk on people, this and that. Now pay attention to shooting. Now this is what I did for shooting. This is my personal preference. So I did quick draw on goal, rage extend of goal, difficult shots, solver, and green machine. Only reason I put difficult shots because I take a lot of shot, dribble shots, so that's why I put difficult shot. But to me, you don't have to put difficult shot. It's all about how your playing style is and how you feel comfortable with not to the shit. Like, you could put dead eye wouldn't be bad either. You could put a hustle onto, but if you wouldn't put hustle onto right away until you get your hot spot, you know what I'm saying? Because why would you put a hustle onto first and in there if you don't have your hotspot? Wouldn't make any sense. You gotta make sure you get your hotspot, then you put horizontal on. Now for playmaking, the only thing I can say for playmaking is that if you're playing park and pro am, 3v3 pro, okay, so 3v3 pro am or park or stage, me personally for this build, I'll pull quick first step. Handle for this definitely Hall of Fame. You know what I'm saying? It depends how you play, but for me, I put on Hall of Fame. Unblockable on silver. I know unblockable is broken in this game, but at least you have unblockable so that if defense are trying to reach on you, it wouldn't be easy enough for them to rip the ball. And then for the last one, I put ankle breaker. You feel me? Only reason I put ankle breaker on silver just because I just want to break someone's ankles. As soon as I have my playmaking takeover, so that's what I'm gonna do. You could take out ankle breaker on silver because I feel like you don't really need ankle breaker because you already have the playmaking takeover. So once you have the playmaking takeover, you could still break ankles anyway. So I will personally replace ankle breaker for diamond. Maybe I have diamond on silver, or if not, I'll put handles for this on gold, and I'll put diamond on gold. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's up to y'all. Like, you guys could do anything that you want with the playmaking takeover. And finally, we come to defensive upgrades, the badges. Now for defense, this is what I will do. I'll definitely put Clemson Hall of Fame. You guys make sure you guys put on Clemson Hall of Fame, bro, because Clemson Hall of Fame makes defenders pick up the ball. So you need that Clemson Hall of Fame. Intimidate, you could either put on silver on gold, it's up to you. Tyler's defender is a really good badge. It's on the radar. I feel like a lot of people don't really use it, but pretty much, like, when you get tired, you won't, like, like your guy wouldn't be as slow because you have tired defenders, so it's gonna be hard for you, to be tired, especially if you're going that cheesy ass guard that they be going through screens. That defender will help you in the long run. You could pull rebound and chase on Silver, either Silver on gold, it's up to you. Then I put my pick target just because if I'm paying point, like what I said earlier, you know what I'm saying, just guarding guys that just go through screens, you know what I'm saying. I know it's annoying too, like I pretty much be guarding those guards that just be going through screens and that, but that's where the pick dodger comes in. If you're paying rec, you don't really need pick dodge, because I mean you do, but most times I play zone, so I don't really put pick dodger, I just put something else. So yeah, hopefully you guys like this video. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Let me know in the comment down section below what you think about this, bro. Remember, I'm the first ever to make this spell, bro. Easy to wish I should bring us my friend. I don't know. I'm out. Peace.